Yeah. Let's be of good quality. Okay, well, on Prinon. Hello there, are you here to offer incense today? Could you give me a few sticks? No problem, please wait a moment. Here, take them. The sensor is right there. Please go ahead. Fine incense. Alright, pray. Pervases? You're this guy. I'm sorry guys that you had to see me in this state, but you should not do otherwise. It was really hurting me a lot, so I had to take an aspirin. Just to be on the safe end. But yeah, I knew that Zhao was going to be there. Hey, it's just as I thought. You stopped short of stepping into the city again.
Being in the city isn't the only way for me to appreciate the lights and beauty of Lantern Rite. Look, Liyue Harbor lies just beyond this mountain. As long as I stand at this vantage point, I may freely behold the sights of all the kites slowly ascending into the sky. For me, that is enough.
Alright. Sure.
I want to release a shell lantern, and I'd like you to be there for it.
Did you make it yourself?
Yes. I apologize for its crude appearance. I have little skill in that regard.
No, it's amazing.
You are very kind, as usual. Alright. It's time.
Sure. And this time around, we release it with him. Can we see the Zhao lantern up in the sky? It doesn't seem like it. As the Zhao lantern slowly disappears into the tranquil night sky, Zhao's expression softens.
Traveler, thank you.
You're welcome. I was there for you, buddy. Alright. Well, let's go to Chowin Village. Now. Luo. Yeah, that's the idea. Beel fruit. Do we say beel? Okay, cream gummies and beel fruit.
Huh? Did you hear that?
Oh, that's Hutao.
Goodbye.
Yeah, I had it too. Hutao. One lonely.
Well, we've got the time. Why don't we go check it out?
Okay, let's just see what's up. You and Paimon make your way up to mountain in search of the source of the shouting. As far as you can make out, it's almonds this and tortilla paste that. Sounds delicious, that's for sure. The lively voice invigorates your steps, and you ascend the mountain in no time. Oh? Navia and Clorind? Hey, what are you doing here? Hey, what's up, ladies?
You see, I told you that something good was going to happen during our travels today. I have to say, sometimes the Steambird's astrology column is spot on.
It's just your lucky day.
Yeah.
Are you guys also here to catch the festivities? Oh, and that reminds me. Happy Lantern Rite.
Happy Lantern Rite.
Happy Lantern Rite.
Happy Lantern Rite. And to you. Okay, so it was Navia, not Futel.
Oh, impressive. You could tell it was me from that far away. You've got good ears.
From that, or your voice is just really loud.
Well, of course it is. After all, I'm a boss.
Who's the boss?
Indeed. I suppose it's an asset.
I see. So it's not what you were shouting that matters.
Exactly. You get me, partner. I was afraid that it would cause a disturbance, so I asked the locals around here, and they said it was fine. Apparently most hikers like to shout when they get to the top, so the locals are used to it by now. So, you see, it's not just me. I guess everyone shouts from the top of a mountain at some point in their life.
Speak for yourself.
When you're stressed, don't you ever just get the urge to do something for no reason?
Not really. If I ever get stressed, I just go hunting.
Straight to the point. It's going for you.
Oh, that's a pretty good way to release stress.
What I choose to hunt depends on my mood.
Huh? Anyway, why don't you two give it a try? Shout anything you want. It's a real stress reliever.
As long as Paimon has clothes on her back and food in her belly, Paimon doesn't think there's any stress that needs relieving.
And I prefer to keep things bottled up.
Oh, I bet you guys are just too embarrassed to let loose.
No.
No need to be shy. Even Farina was shouting from the top of this mountain earlier.
Wait. So, Farina was here? Who?
Huh? Did Paimon hear that right? Farina's also here? In Chiang Village?
Believe in your ears. It is indeed as you heard. Actually, the reason we climbed this mountain in the first place was also because we heard the sound of shouting.
From her.
Hear what she was saying? Why didn't you say so earlier?
I thought someone was really in trouble.
I figured we would come check out the situation either way. Why not let her keep some privacy?
Oh, seems like you caught Farina in the middle of some stress relief as well.
Seems like it. Was she alone?
I think so. We ran into Nervalette on the way here as well, but he was already on his way back, so they probably weren't together.
So Nervalette was almost there.
Nervalette was here too?
So many people from Fontaine. I mean, Chenuvela is a nice hub for them to have some connections.
What was he doing here? It couldn't have been for vacation.
Well, maybe for the tea, because, you know, Risley loved the collection.
I think it just might have been, actually. But apparently he only stayed for half a day before heading back. He's a very busy man.
Tell me about it.
Nervalette is not the type to take much time off. Taking even a half day for himself is already a huge step in the right direction.
Didn't Charlotte publish an article on the Liyue tea industry recently? Maybe he was inspired to come buy some tea after reading that article. You know, just like you were.
My situation is completely different. I'm here because I was asked to accompany you. The tea purchase is simply an added bonus of this location.
Sure. Which is why you visit Risley most of the time.
You Fontanians and your tea drinking.
Oh, it's not for me. I lost my bet with Risley, and now I have to buy him something.
Well, seems like you're a fitting gift.
You could give him mint plants that you plucked from the side of the road, and he wouldn't even mind.
If only he was that easygoing when it came to talking business. In any case, I'm pretty sure the tea you bought is this region's specialty. What is it called again? Nervalette even mentioned it earlier.
You talked about Sunlo tea?
Yes, that's the one.
Okay, so she's not Lai Xianyun, thank God.
That reminds me. You guys said you only came up here because you heard my voice, right? I hope it didn't put you out. You must have had other plans for the day.
Oh, right. Well, a few days ago, we heard that a friend was going to be in Chaoyun Village, so we decided to come and see if we could run into her.
Oh, dear. We've been chatting for quite some time. I'm sorry for keeping you.
No harm done, partner. Yeah, we should.
No need to stay on our account. We just got up here, so we're gonna stay around for a little longer.
Go and meet your friend. We can meet up in Chaoyun Village later.
Sounds reasonable to me.
Sounds good. We're gonna head down the mountain then. See you later!
See ya! But I'm still going to talk to you. Well, would you look at that? Yeah, dim sum.
Didn't Gumming say something about dim sum being eaten in the morning? Oh, Paimon wonders if we can still get some at this time of day.
Afternoon tea might be more appropriate at this point.
Oh, well that's fine too. Paimon doesn't care what kind of tea it is as long as it comes with some tasty snacks.
I see. I also see Haute Montagne right over there. At least, all is, interwoven horizon spec. Judging based on the health, see so. Truly something marvelous, I suppose. Yep, want to make a bet? Vote for Hustler Hu Tao.
Alright, no time
to wait. Let's go see
who's right. Good afternoon, Hu Tao, Yang Li, Karina!
Alright.
Oh, great, now I'm chatting too.
Sure. It's been so long.
Both without prior arrangement must mean that this is quite the serendipitous meeting indeed.
Oh, so both of you are acquainted with the traveler in Paimon then.
Yeah, I have genuinely failed the passage of time since our last meeting.
Looks like someone learned a thing or two from Zhongli.
Yeah. Happy Lantern Rite to you too, Farina.
It appears you have been to Fontaine.
Yep, we've been.
Given your proclivity to spread good deeds wherever you go, it's no surprise that you would make the acquaintance of a celebrity as illustrious and celebrated as Miss Farina.
That's quite high praise. What I mean to say is, you flatter me, Mr. Zhongli. Although I've built up a certain following within Fontaine, it is no reflection of strength or wisdom. I stand before you right now as nothing more than an ordinary traveler in search of beautiful scenery and creative inspiration. There is definitely more to Mr. Zhongli than meets the eye. I could tell as much from our conversation earlier.
Well, she knows. Well, good. At least you know.
Yeah. Forest, I simply won't have you talk about yourself that way. Does that mean Hu Tao also knows? You may not have heard, friend, but.
But.
Miss Hu Tao. Miss Farina is now one of my esteemed clients.
Yep. Hi, Rose. Yeah, did you hear that, Paimon? She's Hu Tao's esteemed client.
Okay, okay, you win. Guess Paimon will have to break into the hidden stash at the bottom of her shoe.
Do you have even a hidden stash at the bottom of your shoe? I mean, it was Paimon's idea, to be honest. Look at that. It was Paimon's idea. That's her. She was the one making the bet, not me. What's that? What do you mean, nuh-uh?
We just saw you guys standing on the side of the road and couldn't
Well, you know me. Uh-oh, she doesn't like this word, newbie.
If that's the case, then Paimon's guess was also correct.
Oh, that's right. Mr. Zhongli was telling me about some great sightseeing spots in the area.
Oh, really?
You see? Paimon was right, too. If both of our guesses were right, there can be a winner or a loser.
Fine. Keep your secret stash, then. I'll buy you a bowl anytime you want.
I was just joking. Anyway, I should be the one treating you. The funeral parlor is about to bring in quite the sum after all.
Oh, Paimon almost forgot to ask about the most important question.
Yeah?
Something happened recently, Farina?
Huh? What do you mean?
With you enlisting the services of Wang Cheng's funeral parlor and all?
Oh, well, yes.
Really? Oh, no. Paimon is so sorry for your loss. Although Paimon may have not known the person, please accept Paimon's deepest...
Whoa, it's not like that, Paimon.
Huh? But Paimon just thought, since you hired the services of a funeral parlor and all... Hey, it's not that big of a stretch.
Really, Paimon? It's not like you don't know me. Do I look like I know anyone who would ask me to coordinate their funeral? Mr. Tao is simply helping prepare some props for my film. Not too long ago, I read a collection of horror stories from the Yue. The content was spectacular. In fact, I still feel the need to sleep with the light on even now.
Aw, she's scared.
Anyway, that's not the point. Now that Fontaine's biggest star has returned to the stage, I figured it's about time the industry enjoyed a breath of fresh air.
You might even call it a breath of fresh air. You might even call it a breath of fresh air. Okay, I'm out. Yeah, I'm out. I mean, Sino would be proud. Sino and Sayu as well would be proud about that joke. Bad puns all around.
Hey, that's pretty good. I'll have to remember that for my ad poster.
Really? Meant to be.
It was a fated meeting indeed.
Zhongli sure loves his lofty turns of phrase. But if you ask me, it's all thanks to that man who stopped to ask for directions.
But if you ask me, it's all thanks to that man who stopped to ask for directions.
Who was it?
It's someone you know. Wanna take a guess?
It was Nivolette, wasn't it? I mean, we are well connected.
Very impressive, my friend. Your guessing game is spot on today.
Vampress. You tell everyone about your encounter with Navia and Glorent at the top of the mountain. One look at the pitiful expression on Florina's face is enough to convince you to leave out the part about the shouting.
Huh. Paimon never thought Nivolette would be the type to get lost.
I'm sure he didn't get lost. Even I was able to find my way.
Oh yeah? And did never let start with Jean Lee? You know. It would have been great. For him, though, for him, though, swimming would probably be the fastest route of them all.
So, were you the one that pointed him in the right direction,
Hugo? No, it was Jean Lee.
Of course.
No.
I'm also a guide of sorts, you know. So naturally, I also have a great sense of direction.
Nice.
But, speaking of your friend...
What is it?
What about him? He doesn't get out much, does he?
No. No, he doesn't.
No wonder. He was stiff as a board and way too polite. I would have never guessed he was here on vacation if you hadn't told me.
All in all, he was only here for half a day. I'm pretty sure he is the only one who would consider that to be a vacation.
Oh? This gentleman you speak of must keep a demanding schedule.
Yeah, isn't that right, Jean Lee? That would have been awesome.
At the time, it appeared as if Director Hu and Miss Farina were having quite the productive conversation. I know matters of business can take much discussion, so I decided to fetch some tea for them.
Right.
What a shame. That gentleman seems like a sophisticated sort of guy. I actually think you two would have hit it off.
Yep. Truly.
Is that so?
He knows... He definitely. Judging by how Jean Lee's acting and taking into consideration Nivellette's true identity, could Jean Lee have been avoiding him on purpose? Yeah, probably, to be honest. Yeah. Oh, I see. Oh, I see. It's truly a pity.
To borrow Miss Farina's turn of phrase, perhaps it just wasn't meant to be.
Well, with the traveler around, I'm sure you'll have a chance to get to know each other at some point.
Yeah.
That's right. He's got more friends than he knows what to deal with.
I'm good with people. Sure.
Just tell him the Palais Marmonia isn't going to fall apart if he disappears for a few days. He should keep himself cooped up all the time. Even clams open their shells to let in fresh water every once in a while, right?
True.
If he's really that much of a stickler for protocol, he can fill out a leave of absence request. He'd have to approve it himself since he handles that sort of thing now, but you know what I mean.
That does make sense.
Seems like this gentleman is also in charge of something pretty important.
He's, well, not to brag or anything, but he is the fair and impartial Eudex of Fontaine, head of the highest court in the land, otherwise known as the demon who controls all the paperwork in Fontaine. Oh, yes. Yeah.
If I remember correctly, he's already several thousands of years old.
Yeah.
You're quite right, Miss Hutao.
Oh?
Oh?
Traveler, Miss Farina. Those two individuals over there appear to recognize you.
Oh, yeah. So we have on the right side, right? We have three GEO characters. We have a pyro, a hydro, and an electro generator. The only element that is not represented here is dendro. I would like to see Nahida talk to Jean Lee. Everyone circles around you and begins to introduce themselves. Their bodies join on high. Hu Tao's eyes light up when she hears about Lorraine's profession, but a quick explanation from Farina and Navia seems to dispel some of her more, well, misguided ideas. What a shot.
It's getting late.
Yeah. Yeah.
Exactly. Just like in those ghost stories.
Oh my god, Hu Tao.
Paths converge in a wood. Beside them, an old house is stood. If you dare to go inside, not a soul will greet your eye. But if you take a closer look, there may be something you mistook. A candle flickers to and fro, yet there is no wind to make it. What is its secret? What could it mean? In this wood, where mystery screams.
Bars after bars after bars. Yep. Yeah. Okay, well, she's not sleeping tonight. Farina?
Gotta say, Farina, you are really quite the character. By the way, did I hear you mention that Clorian used to work under you? Then you must have also been a leader at some point.
Well.
Well, that's, all in the past now. Besides, being a leader is hard.
Oh, yeah.
It wasn't the right job for me. I prefer how things are now. I can come and go as I please. And get to enjoy the sweet taste of freedom.
God, Farina, you're so wholesome and so sweet. Protect... Yeah. Pretend that I smile.
I see. Well, you've certainly picked an apt place to relax. Chaoying Village is an exemplary...
Chaoying. Well, have you all had a good time?
Only the best. And I've learned a lot, too.
Yeah.
Is that some kind of Liyue term for snacks or desserts?
Oh yes, and you know quite well, the appetite when it comes to desserts related to Farina. Bringing home any souvenirs?
Of course I am. I've got tons of fun things to bring home with me.
Really?
A kite, a parasol, a little tin
parasol
dog that jumps. Oh, and a stuffed toy of a mythical beast.
Ah. Alright, so a stuffed toy of mythical beasts. So, So it's Riswani.
Poor Anne is the one who didn't buy anything for herself.
It's a shame.
So all you're bringing back with you is that tea?
And some tea-flavored hard candies. They're for Siegfried.
Poor Anne isn't much of a shopaholic.
Yeah.
Well, one of us has to practice restraint.
Hey, I'm hardly reckless with my Mora. I'll have you know, all the purchases I made today were well within my budget.
What about Farina?
Me? Oh, well, I bought some tea, of course. I just had to try all the varieties recommended in the steam bird. Other than that, just some bits and bobs, you know. A little bit of this, a little bit of that. They should all be things I can use.
So you fell for a few marketing traps then.
Now Paimon's even more confused.
Don't you worry, Paimon.
If you bought that much stuff, where did it all go? Into one of Winnie's magic packets?
Oh, actually,
Monsieur never meant to come with him.
Oh. Which is why you had to go back?
Oh, so that's... Wait, what?
Yeah.
Wow, he seems like a real gentleman. Maybe he's not as uptight as I thought. If only the funeral parlor had an employee as thoughtful, proactive, and responsible as him.
Hello? Zhongli's in the vicinity.
Right, Zhongli?
Oh my god.
Indeed.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
But we don't know exactly when he'll show up.
Look for Neverlet.
Life is like...
Oh, no, not that.
Oh, that reminds me. A new year of work is about to begin. If there's anything you want to talk about, Zhongli, you know you can come to me. I'm all ears.
Does the director have any concerns?
It just seemed like you were a bit preoccupied today, and much less talkative than usual. He barely said anything other than, "Is that so?" and "Indeed." If you ask me, I'd say you're having a midlife crisis. You're getting to be around that age after all.
Is that so?
Is that so?
I jest, given its distance from the city. Xiaoying Village enjoys a much slower pace of life. Surrounded by such peace and tranquility, I also seem to have developed a proclivity for inactivity.
A proclivity for inactivity.
I apologize for making you worry.
I see. What do you think, Traveler? Is this atmosphere putting you in a lazy mood too?
Out of mind, out of sight. Is that so? Indeed. Wow. Oh. Oh.
Well, everyone, make sure that you've got all your belongings with you before we leave.
Right. So, everyone has all this stuffed?
Doesn't exactly make you seem like the type who enjoys interacting with people.
Well, I try to keep my professional and private life separate. That includes my behavior.
Right.
Take care now, traveler. Paimon.
Don't worry, your partner is very strong.
Ah, trying to act cool now, are we? Well, I guess it's not an act for you, is it?
Nope.
You are indeed quite strong.
Yep.
It's been great talking to you all. I'm really glad I decided to come to Chaoyin Village. Maybe we could go on another trip together sometime?
So sweet. Why is it so wholesome? Yeah.
Few people frequent this location. Since I was able to conclude my work early for the day, I thought I might take a walk and avail myself of this area's peace and quiet.
What do you call this? Early? You always work this late, Neverland?
Strictly speaking, that depends on the agenda for the day.
Yeah.
I am hardly bereft of time, however, so working late is of little consequence to me.
Really? If you have so much time on your hands, then why did you only go to Chaoyin Village for half a day?
First, I should clarify that I was referring to my lifespan, rather than the time at my disposal on any given day.
Right.
Second, I was unaware of the possessed knowledge of my trip to Chaoyin Village.
You give me a letter, quick summary of everything that happened today.
I see. Thank you for informing me.
So, did you deliver the gifts?
Yes, they have been safely delivered.
I have to hand it to Claret. Just a simple gift delivery, and she has the great and mighty Udens at her beck and call. I was just passing through. It was merely an act of convenience. All right. Then I hereby confirm receipt of the goods on behalf of the staff of the Fortress of Merope.
A verbal receipt of confirmation? Is such a formality really necessary for a small matter such as this?
Guess not. This quantity of tea, though, seems a little excessive for a gift, don't you think? Before you know it, they'll start accusing me of taking bribes.
About that, much of that is my own conception.
Oh? Why? What happened?
It was buy 10 boxes, get half off.
It was buy 10 boxes, get half off. He fell for the marketing trap.
Ah, that explains it then. Go ahead and leave them to me. I'll get through this stash as fast as I can.
You have my thanks. Oh, there's something else I'd like to give to you.
This is a stone slate, engraved with a symbolic design.
Well, that is a apt description. It is, in actuality, a legal codex.
A legal codex, huh?
Before the advent of modern writing utensils, information was recorded on stone slabs such as this. The law was no different.
Oh, okay.
Since ancient times, the scales of justice have symbolized the fairness and impartiality of judiciousness. As a tribute to that sentiment, this slate was designed after a traditional legal codex, engraved with a symbol instead of text. During my travels recently, chanced upon a roadside stall offering tourists the opportunity to try their hand at the ceramic arts. So I decided to have a go. We joked with Claran some time ago about gifting you a legal codex. So, here you go.
Ah, so that's what this is about.
I did not expect you to remember it as well. In any case, I hope this can be considered as a reasonable attempt to join in on the banter.
It is a very good attempt. I suppose I shouldn't be surprised. Even your sense of humor centers around the law. That's an impressive level of commitment. A gift of this significance deserves to be put on display, and I know just the place. Front and center in the fortress's showroom.
Ah, surely there's no need for such a grand gesture.
Just kidding. I don't have anything like a showroom. But we do have a storage room. We can put it next to all the mechanical parts Siege Wings collected.
That sounds good to me.
So that's what you were doing in Chaoyin Village!
Indeed. Of course, while I was there, I also took the opportunity to taste the local spring water.
Taste?
The aftertaste is much purer than what I have delivered to me in Fontaine. It stands to reason that the long-distance transport has a tendency to imbue the water with extraneous emotion. If you want to experience the true thing, you simply have to go to the source. Perhaps I should organize some time off to do the same elsewhere.
As they say on Leeway, a balance between work and play is sure to keep your troubles at bay.
Then we are at the same level. It appears my desire is justified.
If you say so, but you know you don't have to justify a vacation, right? You can just take one. After all, you're hardly
bereft of time.
You can do whatever you like.
You're quite right. I suppose I suffer not from a lack of opportunity, neither a lack of inspiration. However, after reading a few articles about Liyue's holiday traditions, the idea popped into my head and made itself quite at home. Seeing as I was free of responsibilities for the morning, I decided to depart at once.
And how was it?
Refreshing. My spontaneous outing seemed to inspire quite a few other spontaneous decisions as well.
Yeah.
Take, for example, my foray into ceramics. At first, soil from the ground is granular and unforgiving, but at the right amount of water, and it becomes soft, moldable, and able to take shape. In the past, I never thought about how quotidian vessels were crafted. But now, I have participated in their very making. This is also something I made today.
Ooh, what's that? It's beautiful. Oh wow, what a big ladle.
That's a ladle?
Ladle.
I thought it was supposed to be some long-necked sea creature.
That was indeed one of my inspirations.
Well, it's amazing. The color also really matches your style.
Really? Do you like it?
Yes.
To tell you the truth, given your unexpected arrival, I find myself quite unequipped to give you the welcome you deserve. Around such an important holiday such as this, human custom would dictate that gifts should be in order. But I'm afraid this is all I can offer. If you're happy with this.
Can I really keep this?
That is precisely why you do me such a great honor if you accept it.
Then I accept. Thank you.
You are most welcome. Happy Lantern.
Oh, that reminds me. You pass along the advice for Nouvellet's vacation.
My proclivity to refrain from personal outings does, in part, originate from a sense of responsibility toward my duties. But it is also due to a lack of desire to engage in the human world. Now I see that the human world is indeed filled with many interesting places to discover.
I shouldn't have told you that. What do you mean, explore the domain? Wait, did we finish, Lantern Rite Festival? Is it over?
Osmanthus wine tastes the same as I remember.
Yeah, we did. Special furnishing gift. A special gift you obtain during Lantern Rite, containing the most excellent furnishing for the realm within. Ah, well. Let's go into the Serenity Pot. Where is it? There it is. a ladle of the leisurely sea beast. A soup ladle gifted to you by Nubulet during the Lantern Rite. Its creation by his own hand was a product of a spontaneous decision during his spontaneous outing, and thus holds exceptional meaning. However, perhaps because the Udex was on vacation at the time, this fantastical sea creature inspired soup ladle gives off a sense of leisure. If this ladle is used to taste various waters, you might perhaps gain insights you would not normally. Alright. A such new let.
Lantern Rock marks the start of the new year in Lira.
Yes.
In the spirit of the season, I wish you a year of success as vast and endless as the open ocean.
Thank you, Nivellet. Alright, well, lads and ladies around the world, I think that this is where I'm going to, well, call it the video, or the stream for that matter. I've been streaming for, 5 hours, so this is high time. This stream was amazing, from the climax, to the Lantern Rite Festival, all the way to having Jean-Louis and Nouvellet talk to each other. Farina, awesome, having a partnership with Hu Tao, and Farina, Navia, and Clarin becoming best of friends. We released a lantern, a Zhao lantern with, Zhao, and Gamin was able to reconcile with his father, and that was so wholesome. But yeah, next time around, I think I'll do the Jian Yun story quest in the next stream, so I guess we'll see how that goes. But if you enjoyed the video on YouTube, and you can't wait to see more in the future, then you know what to do. Make sure to leave a like on the video, also subscribe to that, also subscribe and activate the notification bell so that you never miss a video from me. And also, come over and follow me at twitch.tv/foreveressing, where I do most of my streams regarding Genshin Impact and Honkai Star Rail as well. And yeah, that about does it. Thank you all guys for tuning in. And I will see you all in the next video. Bye, guys.